はい。
Bow Street, and in Bow Street were the swimming baths. It was called the Bow Street Swimming Bath, and this is where, as I suppose children your age, I used to come and go swimming every Saturday. Now have a look up the street here. Can you see at the very end? It's the Roman baths, and in the 1970s there were some superb evenings where the Roman baths opened, and there were some wonderful Roman rendezvous evenings. And girls, your grandparents participated in the Roman rendezvous evenings.
Really?
Isn't that special? Now this building, girls, is the cross baths. And this is at perhaps your age, Harriet, is when Mummy came. And this is where I had my very first swimming lessons. Now this is going to be quite interesting, because when we look through here, we can see the swimming pool. This is completely different to how I've been coming to my swimming lessons for 3 or 4 weeks, and I suddenly noticed that the white flowers were suddenly no longer white, and they were taking on a brown, a very sort of certain brown colour. And I was told that it was the minerals in the water which made the lining of the pool brown, while it was having the same effect on my swimming costume.
I had a personal passion about the spa. I've always been fascinated by Bath's history, and if you look through Bath's history, you see these very interesting cycles of growth and decline. And each one of those cycles through history, the Roman, the medieval, the Tudor, the Georgian, which is probably the most famous of all the phases, each of them was stimulated by the reinvention of the spa and by the use of the hot springs. And I think all of us on the project were absolutely obsessed with the idea of bringing the spa back to life and in a way reconnecting the city to the hot springs. And I remember it as if it were yesterday. We were actually in this building downstairs next to a fax machine, all sort of pacing the room like almost like expectant parents or whatever, waiting for this fax to come through from the Millennium Commission and not knowing what the result would be. So it was, you know, we sort of cracked open some champagne when it came through, and it was a really exciting day.
Within the pool itself, as well as the lovely thermal waters which are just bubbling up underneath us at the moment, it's got a lot of nice extra features, whether it be the whirlpools and neck massages, the jacuzzis and so on. We're now in one of the 12 treatment rooms surrounding the hot bath. With all of these treatment rooms are fed by the natural thermal waters, and this particular one is a great facility called the Vichy Shower. This isn't just normal hay, it comes from Salzburg area in Austria. Then the heat comes from the back, it works its way through the hay, and then with the, not just the aroma, but also the natural ingredients in the hay, works its way into your back and shoulders. This is the cross bath, which is really the oldest of all the baths and springs that we're going to be using. A little special priority access for the local residents as a little way of saying thank you for using your particular waters.
What to do with those who didn't want to keep any longer. So I broke away from the Church of Rome, threw all the monks and nuns, because the ancient Britons believed this was very holy, very magical water. Four of them, one after the other. As far as bath is concerned, it's appeared from round about dirty, filthy, smelly hovel you would not have wanted to have come to in 173. Before, notice if you go into the Roman Bath Museum, once they've taken the 11th, the 12th and the 14th centuries. And a building of that age, you'd expect to see more wood in the fabric of a lot of the buildings. And you'll see examples of that as we're going around.
I'd been working for 7 years on the project, and the whole purpose of that time had been to get the buildings open and to get people into the thermal water. And all of a sudden, our expectations were dashed when we realised that the buildings wouldn't open.
We had all our staff ready to go, ready to open, but my colleague, our technical manager, came along and said, "Peter, I think we may have a problem with some of the pools." I said, "What do you mean a problem?" So we came in and literally we just got down on our knees and with our fingernail we just scraped very gently the surface, the paintwork of the pools. And what happened? Little flecks of paint came off on our fingernails. The day after the three tenors, Pavarotti, Carreras and Placido Domingo, the day that they left, we literally pulled the plug on the pools, and it became apparent of how widespread the problem was, because on the paintwork there were hundreds of little air bubbles and somehow water had got behind the paint, which really meant that there was the problem, which we thought was small, was much bigger and much more significant than we ever imagined.
taken ages. It was supposed to be a millennium project and everyone was really excited about it. Mm. And now it's just a drag really, and everyone walks past the site just down there and it's all boarded up and it looks terrible really.
Well, I think it's a scandalous waste of public money. Of my money and other people's money. As far as I'm concerned, it's a white elephant. It's taken too long to build, at vast expense, and that money will never be recouped by the council.
He did produce a son. A certain amount of scandal. The king hadn't been here at the time, so there was still a bit of partying going on. All that would be her way of amusing herself while she sat there. To go around that corner. It all got held up and everything's gone a little bit pear-shaped. We've had quite a lot of trouble with getting the buildings finished and so on.
It's given me a real buzz here today because for the first time in over 2 years, I can actually see the bath, this thermal bath, with actually water in it again. There's been so many false dawns, there's been times we've been told they're going to be handing over on this date, and this date. Loads of targets, almost all of them were missed. There are people actually physically working, and in terms of then actually seeing the progress that's being made, it gives me faith and hope that the end's in sight.
There appear to be new contractors in there now, and I think everyone is fairly optimistic this time that just about everything that has gone, that could have gone wrong, has gone wrong.
Now, you might be familiar with the other pump room, which yeah. Is near the Abbey in Bath. Is that where?
Around the corner. Very much part of my childhood memories. I'm part of my family's. Myself, my two older brothers and my sisters all learnt to swim in the crossbars. Well, I'm hoping that my own children will have the opportunity as I did to swim in the hot spring waters, and if Harriet could learn to swim as I did in the crossbars, then I'm sure that she would be delighted.
There was concern locally that the city mustn't become a heritage theme park, that it must have some element of vitality to it. And I think the hot springs were seen as the key to unlocking that.
I mean, I think we've been through a rough couple of years in terms of the perception of the project, but I think as the closer we get to it opening, I certainly hope that people will start to feel a sense of pride that we have got, you know, those hot springs back in use. And I think there'll be all sorts of spin-offs. I think once it's open and people can see what it is and experience it as well, and I think also once it starts attracting more staying visitors to the city, contributing to the economy of the city, and most of all, I think contributing to the identity of the city, giving Bath its sort of distinctive identity back, I think that people will be pleased that we've done it.